Namah Shivaya students, today in our physics class we shall learn the pattern of the magnetic field due to the current through a state conductor. Now last day we have already completed that how the current carrying conductor produces magnetic field around it. We have also discussed about the electromagnets and the permanent magnets. Now we shall learn today about the pattern of the magnetic field that is generated by the current through a conductor. Now what is the meaning of this? Now you have already learned that, you have already studied that any current carrying conductor produces or generates magnetic field around it. But what determines the pattern of the magnetic field generated by the current through a conductor? So what will be the pattern of the magnetic field? That means we already know that a strong magnetic field is being created around the current carrying conductor. But what will be the pattern of that field? That we have to study through one experiment. Okay, what will be the pattern of the magnetic field that you have to study? Now does the pattern depend on the shape of the conductor? Now many questions arises that the pattern of the magnetic field, what is the factor that determines that? Or does the pattern depend on the shape of the conductor? Is the shape of the conductor, conductors of many types of shapes, it may be cylindrical or spherical, so does the shape of the conductor is responsible for that pattern? Now see this diagram. Now what I'm teaching, these are very important, and you have to, whatever I have taught you till today, till date, everything has to be written. First you have to understand the concept, go through the NCERT book as well as the things which you are seeing in the video, the notes. After understanding what I'm explaining you, you have to write down everything from the video in your physics copy. Okay, along with the diagram, everything from the video you have to note it down. Now see, so this one you will get in page number 226 of your NCERT book. Okay, now first you take one battery. Okay, a particular voltage of battery, it may be 12 volt. Okay, you take one battery of 12 volt. Next, a variable resistance. Variable resistance means rheostat. Okay, take one rheostat and ammeter. This is one ammeter for measuring the current, and the range of the current should be 0 to 5 ampere. Next, a plug key and the long straight thick copper wire. So copper wire will behave as a conductor. Now join all the things with the help of the connecting wires. Now insert the thick wire through the center normal to the plane of a rectangular cardboard. Now you have seen that this is one cardboard. A cardboard has been placed and the shape of the cardboard is rectangular in shape, through that the copper wire has been passed. Now you should take care that the cardboard is fixed and do not slide up or down. Okay, the cardboard should be fixed, it should not slide up or down. Okay, and the thick wire, the copper wire, should pass through the center of the cardboard such that it is normal or perpendicular to the plane of the rectangular cardboard. Now you connect the copper wire vertically between the points X and Y as shown in the figure, and it should be kept in series with the battery and the plug key. Now next step is you take some iron fillings, okay, small bits of pieces of iron fillings, and you sprinkle or spread it uniformly on the cardboard. Okay, so you take some iron fillings and sprinkle the iron fillings uniformly on the cardboard. Now keep the variable of the rheostat at a fixed position and note the current through the ammeter. Yes, the variable resistance should be fixed. You fix the value and then you note the current by the help of the ammeter. Now the key should be closed. Why? So that the current could flow through the copper wire. Ensure that the copperware placed between the points X and Y remains vertically straight. Yes, that is to be noticed. It should be vertically straight. And key should be closed. Then only the current will pass through the circuit. Next, you gently tap the cardboard a few times. Okay, this is one cardboard and you have spread some iron fillings. Now gently tap the cardboard a few times. Now observe the pattern of the iron fillings. So after the current being passing through the circuit, what is happening? This is one conducting wire. So copper is conducting what? Current is flowing through it, and as a result, what is happening? Magnetic field will generate around the copper wire, and we all know that iron, the magnet attracts iron. Okay, magnet attracts the iron, and you will observe that the pattern of the iron fillings. You would find that the iron fillings will align themselves as shown in the pattern of the concentric ring circles. Okay, what is the meaning of concentric? Center will be one. See, center is fixed. This is one circle, next second circle, and next another one circle. So we shall observe that when the current is being passed through the conducting wire, the iron fillings which were spreaded on the cardboard will align themselves such that it represent the concentric circle. Okay, the pattern of the iron fillings will be concentric circle. That is important. Concentric circles around the copper wire. Now, what do these concentric circles represent? Okay, so concentric circle means a circle with the same center. So what do these concentric circles represent? They represent the magnetic field lines. Actually, they represent the pattern of the magnetic field lines. Understood? So far, we have studied that magnetic field develops around the current carrying conductor. By the help of the cardboard and some iron fillings, we have seen that the iron fillings align themselves in the pattern of the concentric circles. So what does these concentric circles signify? They signify or they represent the magnetic field lines. Actually, these are the patterns of the magnetic field lines. Now, you place a compass at the point P. Okay, you place a compass here over a circle. Over a circle, you have to place a compass. Now, observe the direction of the needle. Now, a needle is present inside the compass. So, observe the direction of the needle. The direction of the north pole of the compass needle would give the direction of the field lines. Okay, so you observe the direction of the needle. You will see that the direction of the north pole of the compass needle would give the direction of the field lines produced by the electric current through the straight wire, which is marked by, then you mark that direction by the help of an arrow. Now you could also carry out this experiment. So this is one way. Now also we can see the direction for verification. What happens if the direction of the current through the straight copper wire is reversed? Now if we reverse the direction of the current, then what happens? Does the field lines, the magnetic field lines direction get reversed? In order to find out this question, you have to perform the experiment. Okay, so from this we have observed that the magnetic field line, the pattern of the magnetic field lines are the concentric circles. So a pattern of concentric circles indicating the field lines of a magnetic field around the straight conducting wire. And in order to find out the direction, you just place one compass near it, over one circle. You place one compass over one circle, and the north pole will indicate the direction of the field lines produced by the copper wire. Okay, understood? So this is the experiment about. The pattern, actually the pattern mainly is the pattern will be of concentric circles, which will indicate the field lines of a magnetic field lines around the straight current carrying conductor wire. Now next we shall study the right hand thumb rule. Okay, now this right hand thumb rule, this rule has been given by Maxwell. Now what is the meaning of this right hand thumb rule? Now the right hand thumb rule is a rule which is used to find the direction of the magnetic field. Okay, with the help of our right hand thumb, we will be able to find the direction of the magnetic field. The direction of the magnetic field, that means in which direction the magnetic field is being moving. Okay, now, and this is given by Maxwell. So this is our thumb. This one is our thumb of our right hand. Okay, this is the thumb of our right hand. Now let us consider if the thumb points the direction of the current. Okay, so if we keep the thumb in this direction, so the thumb will indicate or point the direction of the current, and the other four fingers, the curl of the other four fingers or remaining fingers of the hand will give the direction of the magnetic field. This is the Maxwell's right hand thumb rule. Understood? I'm repeating once. Right hand thumb rule is one of the rule which is given by Maxwell, and this rule is applicable in order to find out the direction of the magnetic field. Okay, now if the thumb points the current, if this one is the current, that means if this one straight perpendicular, the thumb of your right hand, if this thumb points the current carrying straight conductor, suppose if the thumb points the current carrying straight conductor, your curl, the curl of the other four fingers will give the direction of the magnetic field. That means the field lines will pass from in this way, in the clockwise direction. Okay, in the clockwise direction. So if the thumb of your right hand points the direction of the current, then the other four fingers, the curls of the other four fingers will give the direction of the magnetic field. So see, the curls are in which direction? In this direction. That means it is moving from left to right, in this way to this way. Left means left of the plane of the paper. So the curls are moving in this direction. So that means the magnetic field will move in this direction. That means the clockwise direction. Okay. So the statement will be, if the thumb, this question comes, okay, state direct question, state right hand thumb rule. So you will write that this law or this rule indicates the direction of the magnetic field in a direction of the current. And the main statement is, if the thumb of the right hand points along the direction of the current, then the remaining curled fingers of the same hand gives the direction of the magnetic field due to the current. Understood? So if the thumb of the right hand points or indicates the direction of the current, then the remaining curled fingers will give the direction of the magnetic field due to the current. As because we all know that the current carrying conductor generates magnetic field. So we have to know our motive is to find the direction of the magnetic field, in which direction the magnetic field is moving. So if this one is the current, so our magnetic field will move in the clockwise direction. So this is all about the right hand thumb rule. Now in the next class, we shall start the magnetic field due to a current through a circular loop. Okay, now if the loop is circular, before we were studying about the straight conductor, that means cylindrical in shape, the wires are cylindrical in shape, those were straight wire. Now we shall study that if we take a circular loop, and if the current passes through the circular loop, what will be the magnetic field due to the current through the circular loop? That we shall study in our next video. Okay, Namah Shivaya.